I realize that people who watch my videos are very detail-oriented, and they really want to know the truth about the product that they're looking at. For those who are new to my channel, I don't spend time going over basic specs. Those you can find all over the internet. So I will be covering the concept, the construction and design, the performance, roles and application, and then my final thoughts. A tough, affordable, wave-assisted tactile knife seems very exciting with the release of these new Kershaw Emerson knives. But in reality, you can find this combination of features in the similarly priced Cold Steel AK-47 series. Both knives are made in China, of comparable steel. The Emerson here is 8CR14 MOV. Here on the Cold Steel is OS8, very comparable. But based on proven fact, the Cold Steel has a stronger locking mechanism with the triad lock. Two other example of frame lock knives made in China could be the Spyderco Sage 2 and Chalkway, both which cost almost 3 times as much as this Kershaw Emerson knife. So there's definitely some details to look at which constitute the large price gap. The CQC 6K and the 7K here with the Tanto blade offer fans a chance to use Emerson designs in situations where a knife needs to be disposable and it's okay if it breaks or is lost because they're affordable to replace. They all feel very solid with a similar design to what you see on Hinderers. You have the G10 scale, a liner, then you have the frame lock side, and then some form of spacer in between. Then you have 3 body screws, and then the pivot, and of course stop pin. But compared to Hinderers, the frame lock side along with the blade are slightly thinner. So the overall knife feels very sturdy, but also very like compact all in one little space. Lockup is a solid click, and they all have little to no blade play, except some possible side-to-side, I say like movement in a sense, only because these are Teflon washers inside, which then allow for some flex. The Teflon makes a slick but constant taut feeling to the action and masks the obvious possible precision issues because they can be tightened down and still, and basically prevent the side play, but then allow some flex for the movement of opening and closing the knife still. The use of Teflon washers helps streamline manufacturing because a high level of precision like on the Sage 2 and Chalkway aren't necessary. Between the feel of broken in bronze washers or Teflon, that's personal preference. Engagement sits on an average around 50%, which is good because despite a protruding lock bar, just slightly, for easier access, but perhaps not positive effect for any kind of fighting situation. It takes a significant amount of displacement. You have to really move that lock bar quite a distance, and you can feel that, and a lot of tension too, to disengage the lock. The lockup actually feels very strong, similar to a Sebenza. You can see the geometry. When I push on it, I can force it to engage further, but then practically no stick, and then when you open it again, still in that spot. Same goes with this specimen right here. Engaging roughly 50%, push it in, open it, back to where it was. And I really like Sebenza geometry. Flicking open is somewhat still possible because the blade is finished smooth on the flats. And the inside of the scales look to be polished and then bead blasted. Now, it is this reviewer's misfortune that all Emerson designs that have passed through have had an issue with either disassembly or reassembly. On the real Emersons, the issue wasn't the hardware durability, but the fact that the screws were tapped directly into titanium liners, which obviously has a low wear resistance, because titanium can't be hardened very high on the Rockwell scale, which means if you thin the metal too much in one spot, it's easy to roll or bend, so it can't maintain a keen edge, which basically means the threading would easily give. On the Kershaw Emersons, the screws are tapping into actually metal tubes that are inserted into this polymer backspacer, which is nice. The issue here though is the screws are not tempered. Now I did not set out to lose one piece of inventory. My goal was to disassemble one of the knives and see what it would look like stonewashed on the scales frame lock side. And I thought it would be a nice incentive I could throw in for those that purchase from my site. From factory though, the hardware has Loctite on it, and despite using a heat gun and increasingly larger Phillips screwdrivers, the final screw back here completely stripped, You can see all the stripping is from trying to loosen it. It appears to me that these screws are made of some low-end metal. Now this is the first thing one can pick up between these and Taiwan Spyderco's. On the Spyderco's, the hardware is proprietary and using knife-making quality hardware. The Emerson Kershaw's feel to be made of pop metal quality, and you can see that on multiple specimens, where the hardware is soft and there is some initial damage even on the pivots, direct from factory. See that little bend right there in the middle? This one here also has it. The major issue for me is when I look at the Emerson Kershaw's, the metal shows hints of not being water jet cut and then cleaned up by a person, but instead formed from melting, it looks like, then basically made from cast moldings. There's that weird look of like, as if a, you can see it's very strange. That's not what water jet looks like. It's right here on the jimping. Same here with the other one. It almost looks like metal was applied there. Like it's almost like, as if it's a layer of paint or something. This doesn't affect function, and in the end this is very normal for knives at this price point, so it's acceptable. Just keep in mind the different process other knives, such as those Spyderco's I mentioned, also made in China, or Mid-Tex, require because of their superior materials, which then require different machining processes. What the Kershaw Emersons have, though, is style. And from a design standpoint, the knives have a classic and attractive tactical look to them. For performance, I already discussed the lockup. Deployment is only with the thumb or the wave. It's not that smooth. There is a very strong detent, and your finger kind of rests on the lock bar. But again, this is comparable to the cold steel. Both require a thumb opening. The detent is very strong, though this knife will not allow any type of waving or gravity shaking. The ergonomics are great, and all the edges are knocked off, so there's no sharp spots anywhere, and really no noticeable hot spots. Once the knife is deployed, the traction on the G10 is good, and then this lock side has a subtle sandblast. And so the overall, the ergos, plus this deeper lockup engagement, make the knife feel very secure, so it's a great value. In my first video I ever made of an Emerson knife, I mentioned Mr. Emerson and me had a discussion over email about how in serious hypothetical combat situations, stabbing in with a folder is not recommended, especially into possibly a solid object such as a vest, and he even recommends not to do so because it could close on your finger and cut you. It'll cut your finger off. Without getting into what types of attacks are best in knife fighting, these do feel more safe to stab with than the liner lock versions of traditional Emersons because of their heavy feel and this thick lock bar. Kershaw is releasing a liner lock Emerson collaboration such as this one, and the main thing here is I still would recommend, to my personal recommendation, that any kind of knife that's folding, if you're going to use it for such a situation, it's still better to have some sort of safety choil. In this case, the Mini AK has at least a portion that's not sharpened so it doesn't cut your finger right there. But regardless, for these features, for enthusiasts that aren't aware, in serious professions, folders are not likely to see any type of combat anyways. Now, but those adamant and proficient with this knife can make that call. What this knife does allow is for someone to EDC and really become familiar with this knife to the point where they can rely on it and trust their own skills with it. And I can see that happening with this knife for many people. And it's the end user and his or her personal skill. For other professions, it's still a clip to your pocket folder that's heavy. The clip side here is smooth, so there's still a chance of it sliding out. You can reverse it to the G10 side, which will then provide more traction. For emergency cutting or civilian EDC, this knife is great. Talking about roll, I have to mention then collectability, along with durability. These knives are representations of Emerson knives. Those are USA-made knives. And if you're going to collect, then I would say you have to buy the real deal. I don't see these growing in value, and they are mass-produced. Knives like the Sage 2 and Chalkway are part of a series or limited production. Those are also machined using processes seen in high-end custom knives, proprietary hardware, and high-quality materials. If you're thinking you want a knife that will last a lifetime and is complete in its build quality and precision finish, that is why those are more expensive. But in terms of tactical roles, This brings back the Coastal Mini AK-47, or the comparable sized AK-47. Coastal knives get a lot of flack, but the truth is the company makes quality performing products, and is no different than Kershaw in its outsourcing. And the end product is better quality and more consistent than most Kershaws I've come across. That's my personal opinion from a lot of knives passing through. In my opinion, the Coastal design really took into account the processes to make an affordable knife. And on top of that, it appears that it's done without sacrificing too much to the machining processes that make for a more precise end product. I know that the legalities of saying to carry a knife for added protection, but where I live, it's stupid not carry some form of intimidation. I've seen women carry a knife in the waistband of their skirt, and independent business owner friends I have carry pepper spray openly on their belts. And it's their personal choice over lethally shooting someone with a gun, which I do respect. Now, when it comes to products like tactical folders, that's how I base my recommendation. And what makes me content is knowing that the knife is capable. The end of the line for this knife is I am willing to sell it. But it's not superior than the cold steel, in my opinion. I'd feel much more comfortable if the person was buying the cold steel or something like a Hinder XM. But the reality is that isn't going to suit certain professions or the majority of people's budgets. Or it may not appeal to them. And though this knife has flaws, which I'm openly alerting you to on what I think they are, the knife is adequate, and because it is a popular knife, there's the truth that more people will buy it and it will sell better, so more people are going to EDC it. And for me, the best knife is the one that a person is willing to carry, which will lead to them becoming proficient, and it's the CQC Emerson Kershaw's, here is the 7K, and then here's the 6K, that people are going to enjoy using because of their affordability and their style. And so most likely it'll be the one on that day to aid that person. For more detailed pictures, along with some more covering of finer details, please visit my website and look for the 5-point review under the same tab as the actual listing for the Emerson Kershaw knives. Thank you.